Myself, Dr. B. Sadasivaya, Assistant Professor of Botany, Dr. B.R.R. Government College, Jatcharla. Today, we are going to learn about the family Lamiaceae. The family Lamiaceae belongs to the class Dicotyledonae, subclass Gamopetalae, series Bicarpellate, order Lamiales, which is commonly known as mint family. There are 3,200 species belonging to 200 genera were identified throughout the world by the scientists. In India, we have 400 species belonging to 64 genera. In United Andhra Pradesh, we have 63 species belonging to 26 genera. In Telangana, we have almost 45 to 50 species belonging to 23 genera. The largest genus of the family Lamiaceae is Salvia with the 700 species. The type genus for the family is Lamium, which is also has the conserved name, that is Labiatae. These are the some of the important plants of the family Lamiaceae. Anisomelis malabarica, commonly known as Magabira in Telangana. Leonetis nepetifolia, Ranabehri. Leucas aspera, Tummi. Mentha arvensis, Pudina. Asimum tenuflorum, Origanum majorana, Plectantha samboinicus, Salvia officinalis, etc. Now you can see here, this is the Coleus, the genus Coleus with the variegated leaves, and this is the genus Leucas, this is Leucas aspera, and this is Salvia, this is Origanum majorana. Then coming to the habitat of the family, most of the members of Lamiaceae are mesophytes, except Rosmarinus, which is a xerophyte, and very few aquatics present in this family, for example, Mentha species. Most of the members of the Lamiaceae, they are herbs, very few are shrubs, for example, Leonatis, and Stenogyne is a straggler. The root system is taproot system, except in Mentha. In Mentha, it is a fibrous root system. The stem is erect, straggling, or a runner in Azuga, and it is in quadrangular shape, solid, and also hollow. The stem is herbaceous in nature, and also some of the species like shrubby species, they are woody in nature. They are glabrous or pubescent, and the entire plant bodies of this particular family are aromatic because of the presence of volatile oils. And these are the, now you can see here, this is Rosmarinus. Rosmarinus. Now leaf. The leaves are calline, except Harminum. The leaves are radical in Harminum, simple, ex-stipulate, that means stipule is absent, petiolate, opposite decussate, are rarely whorled. In generally, the leaf lamina is in ovate shape. In some species, it is in lanceolate and pubescent, aromatic, whereas in Coleus genus, some of the species of Coleus, which is having variegated leaves with different colors. Now, you can see here, this is Plectantha samboinicus, simple leaf. Again, we are showing simple leaf here. You can see here, these are the cavities which are having oil glands. This is the pubescent nature of the plant body. The inflorescence. There are three major types of inflorescence are present in this family. Number one is thyrsus, very common in Asimum genus, and verticillaster, which is a special type of inflorescence present only in the Lucas and the Leonatus genus, genera of this family. And in coleus, it is in catkin. And in some species like Anisocillus, it looks like a capitulum, but it is a head inflorescence, sorry, spike inflorescence. Let us come to the characters of flower. The flowers are pedicellate, but they are sessile in coleus, bracteate, bracteolate, and eubracteolate in some species. Zygomorphic in generally, except mentha. In mentha, they are actinomorphic. Bisexual and unisexual. The unisexual flowers are present in Iboza. They are, the floral parts are arranged in cyclic. The gynoecium position is hypogynous, complete or incomplete, dichlamydias and heterochlamydias. All the flowers are pentamerous condition. Now you can see the floral parts of the members of the Lamiaceae. Calyx. Here the sepals are 5. They are fused and each sepal is divided into 2 parts. So each divided into 2, hence we have 10 toothed in Lucas. This calyx, the 5 sepals are in bilobed condition, that is 2+3 condition. They are arranged in valvate or imbricate aestivation. Corolla, the petals are 5, they are fused, but it is bilipped. Number of lobes vary in each lip. For example, if you take a Lucas as an example, one lobe which is having 2 petals, the under lobe having 3 petals, whereas in Asimum 4+1 condition. In some species like some genus like Azuga, the upper lip is absent. The 2 lobes fused and looks like a 4 petals in Mentha arvensis. These petals arranged in imbricate aestivation. The next important reproductive part of the flower, that is androecium. Here the number of stamens are very strict in condition, strict in the number. In some genera, they are having 4 stamens. In some genera, for example, Salvia, having only 2 stamens. These stamens are free, but the filaments are fused in Plectranthus. Whenever the number of stamens are 4, they are in didynamous condition and the stamens are epipetalous in nature, that means they are attached to the petals. Whereas in Nepeta, the androecium are sterile. Anthers, Dithicus, Intros, whereas in Salvia, there is a connective tissue. This connective tissue is long and the anthers are separated and it looks like a lever. With this lever, the upper lobe of the stamen is only fertile, the lower one is sterile. Gynoecium. Bicarpellary syncarpus ovary, bilocular in condition, superior ovary, axile placentation, is very common in this family. The gynobasis style is a peculiar character of the family Lamiaceae. What is this gynobasic style? The style bent towards the down and coming side to the ovary part. Hence it is known as gynobasic style. Stigma, bifid in nature. Then, due to the false formation of wall, it looks like a tetralocular, but originally it is bilocular. The single ovule is present in each locule. Now, pollination. Entomophily is very common in this family. The protandry is another phenomenon of this family. The upper lip of the stamens are the upper lip of the flower, which is having reproductive organs. The lower lip is a platform for the pollinator or an insect. So, if we take the genus Salvia, there is a special mechanism of pollination called lever mechanism. Only one lobe of the, I already told now, there are two lobes of the anther. There is a connective tissue is very long, hence they are divided. The upper lobe of the stamen is fertile, the lower lobe of the stamen is sterile. Then, the connective tissue, it moves like a lever. So, the sterile lobes transfers to the flower. When the insect came and entered into the flower and land into the sterile lobe of a anther. When the pressure is applied here in the sterile lobe, then automatically it looks like a lever, then upper lobe come and touch the back of the insect. This mechanism is known as lever mechanism. You can see here, and this is the upper lobe of the flower, this is the lower lobe of the flower. Now, you can see here very clearly, the stamens are touching here, the one lobe of the stamen touching here. This part is nothing but the connective tissue between the two lobes of an anther. It looks like this. If it is a sterile one, which is present in the lower half of the bilipid corolla, and this is fertile one, this is present in upper lobe of the flower. When it lands the lower lobe, then here there is a pressure applied here, then it will come and touch the back of the body like this. You can see here, like this. So, this mechanism is known as lever mechanism, which is present only in Salvia genus of family Lamiaceae. This is another one. Now, fruit. The fruits are commonly known as carcerulus. In stenogyn, they are called as drupe. The seeds are non-endospermic. They are endospermic in only Prostanthera. They are very small. Let us come to what are the important characters of the family. Mostly herbs with quadrangular stems, aromatic in nature, opposite decussate leaves, thyrsus and verticillar stem inflorescence, bilipid corolla, diadenomous condition of stamens when stamen number is 4, gynobasic style, and these are the important characters of the family Lamiaceae. And economic importance, we know Mentha arvensis, the leaves are used as vegetable. Most of the species of Salvia lavendula and coleus, which are used as ornamental plants in nurseries and gardens. The essential oils that are present on the plant bodies of the lamiaceous members, hence there are some oils are extracting from Lavendula angustifolia, the oil which is known as lavender oil, which is used in the preparation of soaps and scents and cosmetics. Like the same way, Rosmarinus officinalis, rosemary oil, mentha oil from mentha species, which are used in preparation of medicine also. The Asimum tenuflorum, which is worshipped as a god in Hindu houses in India. Some of the medicinal plants are present here. Anisomilus indica, the roots of this particular plant used to cure snake bite, treat snake bite. The roots of 50 savulans used to cure fever. The leaves of Leonidas nepetifolia used to cure skin diseases and burns. The leaves of Asimum, which are used to cure cold, cough and dandruff. Plectranthus barbatus, the whole plant, used to cure heart diseases, hypertension and eye problems. Mentha arvensis leaves are used to cure vomitings and vomiting sensation. Then phylogeny. All the scientists who have kept this family under subclass Gamopetalae under order Lamiales. Engler and Prandtl kept this in Tubiflorae. This Lamiaceae is very close to Verbenaceae and advanced in terms of quadrangular stem and the smell. According to APG classification, angiosperm phylogenic group, the genus Clerodendrum, Vitex, Tectona, they are earlier in Verbenaceae family, now they are part and parcel of Lamiaceae. Lamiaceae is also very close to Borazinaceae in terms of fruits, but not other characters. Thank you, one and all.